I'm Nathan of Origami Designs, and today I'm going to be showing you how to fold the Origami Bird piece card. It's relatively straightforward, although there are a couple of difficult steps. I used a 10-inch piece of paper, and it produced a card of this size. Good luck!
Alright, so the first step is to create an X in the paper. You'll do this by first creating a diagonal line. That's called a valley fold. Now, you're going to unfold the piece of paper and create a valley fold with the other two sides. A valley fold is where you fold the paper towards yourself. Now that you have the X in the piece of paper, you're going to be creating two bisecting lines, as indicated. You're going to fold it like that, and that's the bisecting line. You only need to crease the part that I've been creasing in the video. You don't need to crease the very end. Now, do the same on the other side. Now, you're going to fold the tip of the paper to about an inch beyond the center diagonal line that you made before. As you can see, all four of those lines are going to intersect at the same point. Now you're going to mountain fold, which is where you fold the paper away from yourself, the top half behind. Now you're going to valley fold the tip to the other tip so that you don't see any color on your paper. Now you're going to valley fold the very tip as indicated. Now, just flip that over and mountain fold it to the other side so that you can't see it anymore. Now, valley fold the corner to the point indicated. Now do the same with the other side. Your paper should look like this. Now, unfold everything. These folds are going to come in handy later when we're forming the card. With the white side up, valley fold the paper in half. Now you're going to valley fold the corner up along the existing crease. Now you may not get this the first time, but lift it up and squash it down to form a small square. I'll show you again with a few different angles just to make sure you understand. now that you have a square, you're going to valley fold like so. Taking the edges, you're going to line them up along the center of the square. You're going to do that for both sides. It should look something like a kite. Now the next fold you're going to do in origami is called a petal fold. It's the most difficult fold of this piece, so I'm going to show it to you several times. As you open it up, it's going to form a boat-like looking structure. And it may take a little work to get it to look like the video. I'll show it to you again. Fold the tip back and continue folding it until the sides raise up to form a three-dimensional structure. Now take the sides and fold them towards the center until they lay flat. You've just completed the petal fold. Now take the tip and fold it towards the other tip. Now valley fold that in half, as indicated. The next step is going to be a reverse fold where you're pushing the point in along the existing creases. I'll show it to you a few times again. That's what it should look like when completed. Remember, you're folding along the existing creases. You're not making any new ones. You push that tip in so that the very small piece on the far left just sticks out. Now open it up and it should look like that. Flip it over and you'll notice that the paper doesn't lay quite flat. That's what you want. Now, fold that corner to the center line. There should already be a crease there. Do the same for the other side. Once again, you're folding along an existing crease. Now, fold the tip in along the existing crease once again. It should kind of look like a cubic heart now. Here's a quick view of the other side. Now the next step is to valley fold the top down and bottom up on the existing creases. Kind of folding that cubic heart in half, and the other side is going to meet that fold that you just made. Remember, both of those folds are along existing creases. Sorry that the model is a little bit out of the picture, but you should get the idea. Now, as you do this, you're going to slip the top edge into the pocket, as shown. If you don't get it, don't worry about it, it's not that important. Now the next step is to reverse fold the head, and then you're done. You just finished the bird of peace. Congratulations on your completed card.